So as I push his head through, right, I've got a tight Whizzer here. But if I use just my shoulder and Whizzer, it's a lot of grunting and groaning, and it's a lot of torque. In order to put a lot of torque on his shoulder, I have to put a lot on mine. Okay? So I want to take this head and extend this arm as far and deep through the armpit as you can. The further I push his head away, the less pop I need on the backside. Right? So if he maintains good position right here, I'm grunting and groaning and trying to flip him over. But the harder I push his head through, I want his nose to be pointing up towards the ceiling. I'm jamming it through. Now it's just a little boop. Just a little pop at the end. So in that specific position, I almost want to get this arm straightened out. This is the hand that's on the back of the neck. I want to push that head as far through the hole as I can. And that's going to eliminate or reduce the amount of torque you need on the backside off your shoulder pressure to finish it. Okay? So we'll stay on the single leg one more time here. All right? And now we went to a direct sprawl. I'm going to show you how to take this into a front headlock position, okay? It'll go a little faster because there's a million different ways we can finish. I just want to get you familiar with the technique leading up to it, and then your individual coaches can determine, because for the mixed martial arts guys, the finish is going to be different than a freestyle guy or even a folk style guy. So let me show you the general technique and get you into the position. But I used to use this a lot, and instead of jamming the head straight down, right, what I'm going to do is I'm going to push the head away. And then I'm going to circle it underneath my chest, okay? Right now, if I go to front headlock, I've got a 45-degree angle into him, and everything's kind of jammed up, and it's not conducive to what I want to do. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create some space in here, right? The more length I get on his arms, the further his arms are extended, and the further his core away is from my body, that's how I determine if I'm winning the position, right? If he stays nice and tight in here with his chest on my belly, and his head, you know, up in my upper chest and his arms locked, he's winning. So if this is the winning position for me to regain my control and start winning that position, I'm going to make him uncomfortable and put him in a bad spot. So I'm going to try to get away, push him away, push his head down, all the stuff that your coaches will harp on you if you don't lock up this position good. That's where I want to put him. I want to put him in a terrible position. But in order to execute this front headlock, I can't do it from here. He's in too good a shape. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take the palm of my hand and put it right above his ear. Okay? Now, I'm not jamming it straight down kind of like we did on the last one. I'm going to push it away, again, extending this arm. The further I get his head away from my body, the better and easier it's going to be to complete this move. So I take the palm of my hand just above his ear, and I'm going to start extending and pushing it away. Of course, I've got my Whizzer on the backside. I can either cinch it up and lock it up by my chest, or the standard is going to be down here on the thigh, either way. But I'm going to push the head away as far as I can. All right, really lengthen this neck. The longer these neck muscles are, the weaker they are. So the further I push him away, the less strength he's going to have to push back. All right, so I try to push it away, and then keeping my Whizzer, I'm going to step this leg back into a half sprawl here. Right, I don't necessarily need to go all the way to the mat here right away, and he's a competitor, right? So he's not going to let me just flatten him to the mat. So you probably get a half sprawl, push the head away. You're going to get a half sprawl here. And now I'm pushing the head down and under my chest. Right here. But it's got to go away first to create that space to lengthen those neck muscles to weaken his position. We're going away first. And then it's a snap. I'm cupping my fingers and I'm bringing it under my head. My elbow is going to be short into my rib cage here. Not out like this. So without my partner, I've got my Whizzer, I'm pushing the head away, and then I'm going to snap the head down and in. Ending up, you can check your position. This elbow should be right in your ribs. If it's out here or up towards the ceiling, you're doing something wrong. Push the head away, scoop, snap right here. Let's face these guys just to give them a different look. All right, so I've got my Whizzer in nice and tight, locking on your thigh, or you can pull it up. In this position, I'm going to push the head away. I got no play here. So I got to create some space, weaken these neck muscles, push the head away first. That's going to allow me to get at least a half sprawl here. And now I'm going to push the head down and snap it back underneath my chest. Here. All right. My hand position is on his chin. Now you can't turn it like this. The referees will get on you. But you got some leeway. right? Old school used to be lock in the armpit or go across the throat. Just grab the chin. Just cup it like this. Grab his chin so you've got some movement. Right here. Head under the center of my chest. Okay? Not here, right? That's bad. He's going to peek out and come through, right? So it's got to be under the center of my chest from here. Now, like I said, the finish is going to be up to you guys depending on what discipline you're using, what style of wrestling you're using in your coaching and your body type, you know. For me, I keep these elbows in tight. See how my elbows in at my ribs? And I'd snap the head down, boom, block and go. You can shuck it by, right? Right, there's a lot of options. You can drag it. I mean, there's a million different things. So I'll leave that part up to you, but let's get really comfortable working this position, okay? And he could be on a knee here. He can, you know, if he has it lifted up, I was working with some gentlemen over here. If he's got it on his feet from this position with the Whizzer, the two keys are to get your toes to the mat and get this foot to the outside or the inside closest to his hip. If I allow my foot to stay in here or come across his hip like this, I'm in bad shape. He's in control. My objective from this position is to get my toe to the mat. This toe, at least to the mat. So in order to do that, even here I can stamp it, but I just don't have the hip thrust and I can't utilize the Whizzer properly. So I take this foot and I want to get it in between my hip and his hip. All right, should be a hip sandwich right here. My hip, my foot, and then his hip. If it's not between the part of that hip sandwich, you're not in a good position. So I just kind of limp the leg, bring it here, right on top of his thigh. All right, now I've got good power from the Whizzer. Now I'm trying to step. Now I'm pushing away. Now I'm coming here and catch. Okay, so work at both positions. Work on getting comfortable Whizzering. All right, getting this foot to the outside and stepping it flat. Or if he starts on his knee, you can work both positions. All right, and the key is Whizzer. All right, get your half sprawl, push the head away. All right, and you're gonna circle it. You're gonna go away first, and then we're gonna snap it underneath with our elbow ending tight in the ribs. Push away, here.
You count on his resistance coming back?
You'll feel, well, yeah. I see what you're saying. Yeah, you'll feel him kind of, right? This guy's not gonna be a patsy.
Yeah.
He's gonna be driving back into me. So as I push this head away, yes, he's gonna snap back into me. And I use that back momentum and the down pressure to kind of assist. If he doesn't, I'll take it on my own. But a good athlete, a true competitor, isn't going to like being doing that. So we're going to use his reaction to kind of facilitate bringing that head underneath. Okay, so work both positions. One from a complete stand, one from your opponent on one knee. And get comfortable working this with a Whizzer to a head roll. Right into a front headlock position, okay? Make sure your elbows are in tight to your ribs. All right? Question?